In order to delegate effectively as a registered nurse, you need to make sure you assign the right task to the right person under the right circumstances. You also need to be sure to provide the right direction, communication, supervision, and evaluation throughout the process of delegation. The joint statement on delegation from the American Nurses Association and the NCSBN states that nurses need to use critical thinking and professional judgment when delegating a task to ensure that these five rights of delegation are followed. In this video, I will explain the five rights of delegation. Understanding these rights will help you delegate appropriately in real life and on the NCLEX. Throughout this video, I will give you some tips to help you remember what to delegate so you can pass the NCLEX. The right task. Before delegating a task, you need to be sure that it is the right task to be delegated. In order to delegate a task, it needs to be within your scope of practice. It also needs to be within the caregiver's scope of practice and job description. Organizational policies and standards, laws and practice guidelines in your jurisdiction, professional standards and codes of ethics should all be taken into consideration when tasks that can be delegated are identified. When you delegate a task, the task needs to be for a specific client at a specific time to promote desired outcomes for that client. Client needs need to be met when the delegation occurs. RNs should never delegate the nursing process. I explained the roles of members of the healthcare team in another video, but in short, remember that you cannot share your teacup. I have doubled the A in this acronym, but it still works because you really don't want to share your teacup. T stands for teaching. RNs need to do the primary teaching because it is such an important part of health promotion and disease prevention. E stands for evaluation. Others can collect data for you, but the RN needs to interpret it, formulate the nursing diagnoses, and judge client progress towards meeting goals in the care plan. A stands for assessments. Assessments need to be done by the RN. LPNs can do routine assessments, but RNs need to complete initial assessments on new patients, regular follow-up assessments, or assess when there is an emergency or a change in patient condition. The second A stands for advanced interventions. That is things like administering IV medications where specialized knowledge or skill is required. C stands for collaboration. RNs need to be the ones to work with physicians or others on the healthcare team to resolve client issues. U stands for unstable patients. RNs need to be the ones to care for unstable patients. Never delegate care of an unstable patient to an LPN or UAP. P stands for planning. RNs need to be the ones to identify client goals and develop care plans. The right circumstances. Delegation must occur under the right circumstances. Client needs must be assessed. A task, like positioning a client, may be appropriate to delegate to a UAP in many circumstances, but is it right in your current circumstances? It is your job to assess each client's goals and needs. It is also important to consider if safe care can be delivered using the resources available. You need to consider the competency of your assistive personnel and how much supervision is needed for the task. You need to balance the needs of the client with the competency of the care providers available. Be sure that assistive personnel can be appropriately monitored and guided. Do you have the skills and knowledge to safely delegate the task? The right person. It is critical that you are sure that the person you are asking to perform a task is competent to perform that task. You need to assess if they have the knowledge and skill that is needed to perform the task being delegated. Consider any certifications or licenses they may have, as well as training or documented knowledge. Have you seen them demonstrate their competence in performing this task? Have you seen them doing skills? If their competence is not already assessed or documented, you may need to teach them what to do or go with them to assess that they know what they are doing with a specific client or task. You also need to consider how stable your client is and how predictable the outcome is. UAPs and LPNs cannot be assigned to unstable patients. The outcome of the task they are doing needs to be predictable. The right direction and communication. When you delegate, you need to be sure that you have provided clear directions. You must be sure that a specific person was told to help a specific client. The way that delegation decisions are communicated will depend on where you are working. It may be done verbally or in writing. Typically, agencies have set up processes for communicating and dividing client workload. The American Association of Critical Care Nurses Handbook outlines the 4 C's criteria for the right direction. Are your initial directions clear, concise, complete, and correct? You must clearly direct assistive personnel during delegation. The activity that you are asking them to complete must be concisely described. That way you don't confuse anyone. You need to be sure to provide them with complete information about the activity, including what objectives you need met. You also need to communicate the correct limits and expectations for the activity. In certain situations, more specific communication may be needed. For example, if you are working in long-term care and you are monitoring a client's bowel movements more closely than normal, you may need to ask the UAP to report verbally to you if the process normally just involves written documentation. In these situations, you need to let the UAP know that you need to be told within a certain time frame that is different than normal. The assistive personnel should feel comfortable letting you know that they need help or that they don't know how to do something. Feedback should be ongoing and reciprocal. Be open to feedback that can help you improve. Assistive personnel should be involved in the flow of information and recognized for their efforts. A simple thank you can help promote an environment for open communication. When problems arise, get them involved in brainstorming potential solutions. The right supervision and evaluation. Once a task is delegated, your job isn't over. You need to monitor the completion of the task since you are still accountable for ensuring safe client care. An RN or other licensed nurse needs to supervise certain nursing activities. After clear directions and expectations are given, there is a need for ongoing monitoring and feedback. You can give the person you are working with feedback about how they are performing the activity, and they can give you feedback about how you are delegating and communicating. Make sure you respond to questions and help in problem solving as needed. Whenever needed, you should intervene to promote safe client care and learning for the assistive personnel. As long as you approach it in a professional and caring way, people should be open to your feedback. Be sure you document delegation activities using the methods appropriate in your setting. Do not forget to evaluate how things went. Evaluation is an important step in the delegation process. Both the client and how the task or activity was performed should be evaluated. Evaluation enables quality improvement and professional growth for you and the people you are working with. Are staff reporting when the tasks are completed and how the client responded? Are you providing appropriate teaching and guidance? Are issues or problems being reported properly? If you like acronyms, you can use DPICS to remember the important components of the 5 rights of delegation. Everyone refers to it as 5 rights, but there are more than 5 things to remember. I just changed communication to interpersonal communication so I could fit all these elements into one word. When you follow the 5 rights of delegation, you will be able to delegate properly in real life and on the NCLEX. Thank you for watching. Please comment below and let me know if you found this video helpful. Also, let me know if you need more information about something to help you pass the NCLEX. I am working on a playlist now that will help you study for and pass the NCLEX. Subscribe if you want to be notified when new videos are released.